Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I'm gonna show you a 2011 Indonesian action thriller film called The Raid: Redemption. Spoilers ahead. Seat back, relax, and enjoy the video. The movie begins with Rama, wearing black pants and a white shirt, kneeling on his prayer mat, bowing his head onto it, placing his both hands on the side while he recites his prayer. After he ascends from bending, the clip transitions to him, wearing only his pants while doing rapid pull-ups on a bar. Then, the clips alternately transition to Rama reciting his prayers, and doing excellent body training such as curl-ups and boxing, flexing his well-defined abs, bulky bicep muscles, and tan skin. As Rama finishes his routines, he goes out of the bathroom and proceeds to their bed, where his pregnant wife lies. Rama gently says his farewell to his wife by kissing her forehead, and saying his love to her, and to their baby inside her wife's womb, promising that he will soon get back home. As Rama walks along the hallway of their home towards the main door, he meets his father. As Rama looks at his father, the fire of determination burns with his gaze, igniting the bravery he has gathered for a long time. As he opens his mouth, Rama releases his final words to his father, saying that he will bring Rama's little brother back. In the morning, a bulletproof car that carries new police recruits is on its way to their target. Rama is one of the police team. Their target is to take down the crime lord Tama Riyadi, who is known to be a legend in the illegal underworld business of making a medicine that leads to addiction. For a decade, Tama Riyadi's building signals a threat for police to not take it down because it is equivalent to a danger of losing one's own life. Tama Riyadi's allies and protector live in the said building, willing to fight for their master. This notion signifies a warning to all, and must be kept avoided, except for Sergeant Jaka, who preaches the evilness of Tama, and says to his fellow comrades to do their mission, to go into the building, and take Tama out. In his last reminder, Jaka introduces Tama's two guards, Mad Dog, who is willing to break his bones and pour his sweat and blood into protecting Tama, and Andy, the brain of Tama's underground business. When they receive a signal from the driver that they are about to reach Tama's building in 30 seconds, Jaka's firm voice travels inside the car, warming up his team to gear up. As the vehicle gets to Tama's location, Jaka, Rama, Dagu, Boo, and other police go out. Jaka meets Lieutenant Wahyu, who is waiting for them beside Tama's building. As the team lines up, Jaka sets himself in the first line, leading his team in covering the building. Jaka instructed his team to split into two. The first line proceeds in the back of the building, while the second line covers the side. The second line successfully goes through the building, and travels near the entrance to kill one of Tama's lookouts. This clear move signals everyone to gather, and go to the main entrance of the building, where they spot a resident of the building named Gofar, carrying a bag of medicine that he buys for his wife, and is about to enter the building using a key. Gofar is puzzled when the team prevents him from entering the building. Rama asks for his room number, Gofar says room 726, and then convinces him to stay calm until they secure the area. Using Gofar's key, the team enters the first floor, and immediately proceeds to room 104 to pin down one of Tama's allies. After they successfully clear the area on the first floor, the team goes to the second floor, and others proceed to the third and fourth floor, to clear the areas. The group separates themselves by two to go inside each room to catch Tama's members. Some try to escape, while others are sleeping as they get caught. As the team reaches the fifth floor, they walk silently in the hallway between the rooms. Sergeant Jaka and Lieutenant Wahyu walk first with other team members towards a door in the middle of the hallway when they see a teenage boy stop in front of the middle door. Jaka tries to stop him from doing anything malicious, but the boy runs inside the door and shouts, "Police!" to another boy lookout from the sixth floor of the building. This act signals Lieutenant Wahyu to pull his trigger and shoot the lookout in his neck. Sergeant Jaka and his team try to prevent the other lookout from signaling Tama of their presence in the building, yet Tama sees them already in his CCTV monitors. After learning about the invaders, Tama commands Mad Dog to lock down the building, and he calls his two sniper associates from the other building to cover the area outside. One of the snipers shots the police outside the building, while the other shots through the room's window on the fifth floor, where two police guard one of Tama's allies. The shot hits the right eye of one police standing at the window, which makes his partner inside the room come to him, shake him up, and hope that he will survive. This allows Tama's accomplice to crouch his body, put his tied hands in front of him, grab the bolo knife under the table, kill the other police, and snap his gun. As the accomplice exits the room, he clears the fifth building by killing another police who secures the said floor. On the other hand, after Sergeant Jaka and his comrades fail to prevent the lookout on the sixth floor from alarming Tama of their presence, they gather around the deep, square-shaped center of the building on the said floor. Tama takes this opportunity to switch the building's electricity off, puts his mouth in front of the intercom microphone connected to speakers around the building, and announces the invasion of Jocka's team in their place. He encourages every tenant to get rid of the police's presence by offering them a free rental charge if they successfully do it. With all the sweat and tension arising from Jocka's team, he immediately goes to Lieutenant Wahyu and requests him to call their police department to back them up. Jocka is puzzled by Lieutenant Wahyu's act of not doing his request, so he persuades him until he finds out that their department does not know they will be having an operation. Lieutenant Wahyu sets up their team alone, prohibiting them from requesting assistance. Furiness and shock are evident in Jocka's face while looking at Lieutenant Wahyu with dismay, and warns him to stay put on their raid. The sound of doorknob clicks from the room at the back of Jocka and others catches their attention. Jocka proceeds to cover up the door by signaling some police forces to position themselves around the entrance door. The door slowly opens, creaking its sound in the silence of the building. Even the fire of the matches can serve as light on its blinding darkness. While others wait to who's about to come out of the room, one police serve as a lookout for possible threats. His sharp eyes capture suspicious silhouettes on the sixth floor as he scans in the dark. His dilated pupils allow him to recognize groups of armored people, each holds a trigger that points directly at them. Jocka, on one end, slowly raises his weapon directly towards the door as it opens gradually. Before the lookout police signal him to stop, it is too late. Jocka fires his weapon before the door fully opens. The small bullet coming from his weapon serves as light, hitting up like a burning shooting star in the pitch black darkness of the building, enabling the opponent from the sixth floor to see the police in a blink of seconds. This lets them start firing their extensive and lengthy armors towards Jocka's team, which kills four police in an instance. The exchange of fires between two opponents is ear-splitting. Every strike feels like an ice pick that plucks each of their ears. The police hide behind the wall and pull their trigger towards the other end where their opponents stand. Everyone is fighting for their lives, yet some fail to survive, shedding their blood on the floor while Lieutenant Wahyu is horribly sitting behind the wall, not striking even a single bullet. The following clip shows Andy walking furiously towards Thomas' monitor room. He questions their impulsive move of fighting against the police. Andy argues that the police may send reinforcements and tear them down. Tama assures him that everything is under control while he looks at Lieutenant Wahyu on his monitor, pointing out that he is the man behind this surge. Andy looks at the monitor that shows Lieutenant Wahyu, then his eyes travel to another monitor on the side, then look closely when he sees Rama, firing against the tenants. In the middle of the surge between the police and the armored tenants, behind a closed door, comes a thudding sound of people running that captures Jocka's attention. He orders the remaining police to fall back and go inside one of the rooms. After making sure that the room is clear of tenants, they lock the door by placing a sofa and a cabinet behind it. Even after getting inside a room, the shooting still continues when one police is hit by striking bullets after walking towards the window. Having no backup from their department, and the lives of some police have taken, Jocka decides that they should get out of the building. Therefore, Rama breaks the floor using an axe to get their way on the room below, and starts shooting the tenants who fight against them. The room where the police are now located is the target of the furious opponents, ready to attack them. The police defend themselves by shooting. Wahyu now starts to fight with them. Rama opens a tank in the room, places it inside the empty fridge together with their explosive weapon, and with the help of his one comrade, they put it behind the door where other tenants are coming. Right before it explodes, the police and Rama successfully go away from it, killing almost 30 tenants, and breaking no more than two rooms, including the room where Rama and his team are hiding. Before the remaining uninjured tenants come to their room, Jocka, Rama, Wahyu, Dagu, and the injured Bo quietly escape. After learning about the explosion, Tama orders Andy and Mad Dog to get down and take the lead to control the situation. They call five men to back them up, but Andy wants to do it alone. Mad Dog declines and orders two men to be with Andy. Three different groups of tenants are scattered around the building to haunt Jocka's team. The first is the Machete Gang, consisting of men carrying Bolo as their weapon, now searching on the fifth floor. The second is the group of Mad Dog with three other tenants, while the third is Andy's group with his two assistants. On the other hand, Rama and Boo, separate to find room 726, where Gofar leave, so Boo can hide and rest. While Jocka, Wahyu, and Dagu hide behind the small space between the rooms. Before Rama and Boo reach room 726, different tenants from the floor come out to attack them with their Bolo. Rama immediately places Boo on the floor and attacks them using his knife and baton. Every move splashes blood on the walls along the hallway, making Rama successfully kill each of them and defend Boo and himself. The last person that Rama kills on the floor is the tenant who carries a firing weapon, but Rama grabs it and fires at him instead. This thudding sound of fire captures the attention of the machete gang on the fifth floor, and immediately proceed their way up to the seventh floor. When Rama and Bo reach Gopher's entrance door, the machete gang already reached the seventh floor to find them. Rama pleads with Gopher to let them in, yet Gopher only listens to him behind his door. Even if he wants to help, Gopher is afraid to get involved in their fight. In addition to that, his wife also prevents him from letting them in. When Rama senses that the gang is near, he begs more until Gopher opens the door before the gang sees them. After getting in, Gopher immediately assists them in getting inside the small space behind their living room, a thin wood that the picture frames hang separates this small space from the living area. On the other hand, the gang searches for them by breaking every room on the floor. When they finally break into Gopher's room, they dig in every corner yet fail to find Rama and Bo, so they hurriedly walk outside the room to search further. On one end, Andy and his two assistants take the elevator. Using his knife, Andy suddenly kills the two men inside the lift and goes out alone. Rama, on the contrary, entrusts Bo to Gopher. Then, he leaves alone to find how they will be able to escape. Rama is immediately welcomed by the tenant's attacks on his way out. He tirelessly defends himself and goes up to the eighth floor, yet he gets trapped in the hallway, leaving him no choice but to fight and kill the gang. Covered in sweat and blood, Rama ambles when he is exhausted from fighting. He catches his breath and tries to gather himself up until someone grabs him and pin him on the wall. Rama fights back until he sees the face of his brother, Andy. On the other hand, Mad Dog's group goes after Jaka, Wahyu, and Dagu in one room. His two assistants go after Wahyu and Dagu, who run outside the room, leaving Mad Dog and Jaka fighting against one another without any weapon. Bone cracks, screams, and loud thud of each other's bodies keep on happening until Mad Dog wrings Jaka's neck, taking away his life. Going back, Andy hides Rama inside his room, and after a while, they talk. After Andy is gone for 6 years, Rama says that he finds out where Andy is by seeing his photo on their board in the police department, yet Rama remains silent about his relationship with Andy as his brother. Rama says that his main reason for going into this operation is to get Andy back home and be with their father, but Andy refuses to meet his father, who treats him as a disappointment. Andy gains his powerful identity under Tama, and he does not want to let it go. After they talk, Andy goes to Tama's monitor room on the 15th floor, while Rama goes to the 4th floor where he meets Dagu and Wahyu, hiding inside the room. Knowing already that Wahyu sets them up, Rama puts the pressure on him to help them get out. This leads them to plan on making Tama surrender to them by going to the 15th floor, where Tama's monitor room is located. In the monitor room, Andy screams loudly when Mad Dog stabs his right hand. Tama finds out in his monitor about Andy's traitorous move of keeping Rama alive. On the contrary, Rama, Wahyu, and Dagu fight their way up to Tama's room, pouring their strengths to kill people, including those people in the laboratory, where the addictive medicine is manufactured. On their way up, Rama stops when he hears his brother's scream from Mad Dog's punishing hands. He goes inside that room, and both brothers end up fighting against Mad Dog fist by fist. On one end, Wahyu and Dagu successfully reach Tama's room. Wahyu points a gun at Tama, commands Dagu to tie him up, yet instead of hitting Tama, Wahyu fires his weapon at Dagu, and orders Tama to get him out of the building. The next clip shows Rama and Andy pushing all their strength to fight against Mad Dog until they kill him by striking a broken glass from the fluorescent into his neck. After shooting Dagu, Wahyu makes Tama his hostage by pointing his weapon to his head all their way down. In their conversation, Wahyu finds that the reason why the leaders of the underground business sent him into Tama's building is to let him get killed, not to replace Tama in his position and get promoted. After realizing that he has been fooled, Wahyu kills Tama by shooting his head, and then, he is about to also end his life by doing the same thing, yet the weapon is out of load. This enables Andy and Rama to capture Wahyu and tie his hands. The movie ends with Rama, Wahyu, and Boa leaving Tama's place safely under Andy's assistance. As they go, Andy and other tenants prepare to leave before the police department arrives and tear the building down. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this to help the channel out. Have a nice day.